Hey, what's up guys, this is GamersClub24x7 and we are back with another video on this channel. So I have been not making any of the videos from a long time now, so I thought making a video would be a great deal for you guys, and I'm making this a complimentary video on a topic that I have previously posted, that is running Rules of Survival on a 2GB RAM PC and a Pentium processor. And actually, after posting that video, there were a lot of you guys asking me that so-and-so specifications would be able to run this game or not, so-and-so specifications would be able to run this game or not. So wait a second guys, let me mute this so that you don't get double audio. So I am making this complimentary video to let you know which all specifications would be able to run and which all won't be able to run. So there are, I have divided PC specifications into four different categories, and those are the high end users, the middle rangers, the low rangers, and the one which have PCs just for office user, or like the pieces that actually can't do gaming and stuff. So please, what we can say, so I'm going to show you, I'm going to tell you which all pieces are going to able to run on what all FPS and what all settings, and should you actually download the game or and play it on your PC or not. So first of all, let's go for the high-end PCs. Now high-end PCs include the ones which come in, what we could say, i7 processors or AMD Ryzen's newest processors, and don't know what kind of different types of processors are available out there in the market. But all those processors can actually run the game at ultra settings without what we can say much of the graphical needs, like an exterior graphic card or stuff. But you won't get a very high FPS in there, maybe in 50 to 60 FPS on ultra settings or something. That's what I think so. But if you add up a graphics card, it would be much higher, maybe 160 FPS or 180 FPS, depending on how your PC performs, and also the RAM that you have, like 4GB RAM, 6GB RAM, or 8 gigs of RAM. So these all PCs can actually run on ultra settings to this game, and there are not going to be any problem with their PCs while running this game. So also there are no need of RAM boosting apps or any stuff, because it's firstly a gaming PC. When we say a high-end PC and stuff, it can do all the different stuffs, like what we can say, wait a second, video editing, or making the, what we can say, your custom thumbnail, or making your own intro and all the stuff. So those type of PCs can easily run the game on the highest possible graphics and highest possible FPS. So now next comes the middle rangers. Now middle rangers have the middle range type of AMD processors, or the Intel's a little bit older generation processors, like Intel i5's 4th or 5th generation processors, or with we can say even a 2nd or 3rd generation processors. These type of PCs can also run Rules of Survival at high settings. I guess it can also run on ultra, but I won't recommend you to go for ultra settings, because it might even create a frame drop, or also can create a horrible experience for you guys while playing if your PC is not performing good with other games also. depends how much old your PC is and everything, stuff like that. So it's totally what you can say, your wish whether to run on Ultra or not. I won't recommend you to run it on Ultra, but you can easily run on high settings, I guess, and with FPS you can easily get what you can say, and around average of same FPS, I guess, the one which we are going to get on Ultra with high-end PCs. But as your PC might be an older generation PC, or the one which is an old gaming rig, so you might get FPS a bit lower, but to be honest, it won't be lagging at all. It won't be lagging. Your game won't be lagging, and it would be a smooth experience, even though how much ever, what you can say, it's an old PC and something like that. You need not have to worry about that. Just you will get a little bit lower FPS than other gamers. So please, it's your wish whether to run on whichever settings of the graphics you want to. Now next comes the low enders. Now low enders are the people which run on i3 processor, also the ones with with i3, or the one which have the Pentium processors, like the one that I have right now, Pentium G series, or i3, or the Intel i3s, which are a bit older generation PCs, like second generation, third generation, or fourth generation. All these people can run Rules of Survival without graphics card at max, at what you can say, medium settings without graphics card, and it would be around 50 to 60 FPS, or even 80 to 90 FPS, depends on how your PC performs. But there should be significant amount of RAM installed with it if you don't have a good graphics processor along with it. I mean to say GPU. So in my PC, build, when I was making that video, I had a 2GB RAM PC and a Pentium processor, but it wasn't that very old or a low end PC. I still had a a DDR3 RAM along with my Pentium processor. So DDR3 RAMs are a bit newer than what you guys might have, like DDR2 or DDR1 RAM, and the amount of RAM that you have installed. So that might be difference in your RAMs and the type of rig you have, so that might affect seriously. So first of all, when you are trying to run the game, don't just check the amount of RAM that you have, also check the which type of DDR RAM it is, like DDR2, DDR3, if you don't have a graphics card along with it. Actually, with the PCs which have which are run on graphics card, generally have at least a DDR2 RAM, if not DDR3 or DDR4, but you should still check it before doing anything. So it is my older stream a little bit, so it's lagging and the stream quality is also bad, so never mind that. Now for the very low enders, now these people are someone like they have PCs like which are for generally made for office use and stuff, like with 1 GHz processor or 1.4 GHz processor, and they are generally on Intel Celerons or AMD's very old processors, but they still want to play high-end games and stuff. So actually I won't recommend you to run games like Rules of Survival or even a PUBG mobile emulator on that, because it's gonna be quite a bit problematic for you guys to run, or even sometimes it might not even run it. What next I can say, you can sometimes also get serious lags, or even your game might get stuck over something which you won't like to do, and it will overall give you an horrendous experience. And even though if you can run it, it is only possible by using the game booster apps and all that stuff, and even the RAM booster and overclocking apps and all that stuff, but it depends totally on you whether to do so or not. It's like it is not what we can say recommended by me. It is totally on your side whether to do so or not. Actually I won't recommend you to do so, because it might even damage your PC, or you might get serious problems with the chipset and all that stuff. So that's all I wanted to say, and I guess I am going to pin this video's link in the description of my that video. So if you have any doubts, do check out this video. And I'm also going to write a note below it that if you have doubts regarding Rules of Survival and all that stuff, you check that out. Thanks for watching. This is Gamers Club 24/7. Don't forget to subscribe the channel and also like the video if you really loved what I said. And that's all for now. I'm going away. Peace, guys. Peace.